ASICs work because it's easy to create hardware to compute just a certain puzzle, and they're computation bound. A way to get around the problem of ASIC domination is to make puzzles that rely not only on computation speed, but also on memory, giving rise to the notions of memory hard and memory bound problems. A memory hard problem is one that needs a large amount of requisite memory to solve, and a memory bound problem is a problem that scales based on the amount of memory that you have. These problems deter ASICs since optimizing computation is useless if memory is a limit agent. Dogecoin and Litecoin implement a memory-bound hash function called Scrypt. They still use a partial hash pre-image puzzle like in Bitcoin, just with a different hash function. This means that ASICs that are built for Bitcoin don't work for Dogecoin or Litecoin. Scrypt was originally designed to secure passwords and make them hard to brute force, so a memory-bound type of problem makes sense. Scrypt has two main steps. First, we fill a buffer with interdependent data, and then access the data in a pseudo-random way. To see why this is memory-bound, let's take a look at what happens when you fill a buffer with non-interdependent data. Looking something up is easy, since you just find the index of datum that you want. However, if the data is interdependent on other pieces of data, you have to look up those too. If those aren't stored in the buffer, then you have to spend time computing them on the fly. Depending on how much data there is, this can quickly become infeasible, meaning that storing as much interdependent data in memory is the only efficient option. And that's what makes Scrypt memory bound. However, Scrypt also has its drawbacks. It requires an equal amount of memory to verify, since verifiers have to fill and access an equivalent buffer with the same parameters. Remember that puzzles should be easy to verify, so this is not ideal. Or in addition, even though Scrypt was developed to be ASIC resistant, an ASIC has actually been developed for it, so it's no longer considered ASIC resistant. Another idea to achieve ASIC resistance that people have tried was to chain together a bunch of hash functions. The idea was that it is much harder to create an ASIC that can deal with so many hash functions, not just one. And that was the idea behind X11 and X13, which chained together 11 and 13 hash functions together, respectively. The cryptocurrency Dash uses the X11 hashing algorithm using a chain of SHA-3 variants. Dash's X11 was designed to be hard to make an ASIC for, but not impossible, so it was never really intended to be ASIC resistant. Dash's developers wanted to get a good distribution of coin early on in Dash's lifecycle. Later on, if someone happened to develop an ASIC for X11, the coins would have been already distributed in a fair way. And that's exactly what happened. Another idea that was tossed around was to design coins that periodically switch mining puzzles, making it difficult to optimize. For example, it could switch around from SHA-1 to SHA-3 to Scrypt for 6 months at a time each. However, the overhead required to create such an algorithm has historically deterred people from implementing it. As a closing note, whenever there's money that can be made, someone's going to be working to make the most profit. In cryptocurrencies, that can take the form of working to create ASICs for new hashing algorithms. Mike Hurd, a Bitcoin core developer, said, quote, "There's really no such thing as an ASIC-resistant algorithm.